The Tzemach Tzedek said that until until he was 9 years old, he used to go out of his house by Pia Schaefer. And until his wedding at 14, he used to go out of his house by Brett Swain. And he said that he noticed in Dov Kuf Nun Tess, by Tiers and Yotif and Shona and Sukis, in Kippur, he was out of his house and saw by now the Rebbe that Matzen is going to play with, and it's a very good Matzen. And that can happen that on Cholom and Sukis is when they came the rest of the Tzar, the Papa Lebbe, he checked it out and saw that the things that he wrote them were true. So he sent the police and they went the rest of the Rebbe and was Cholom and Sukis. When they came from the room, the rest of the Rebbe, so they came in from the front door, but now the Rebbe, he went out from the back door, he went away, he went to hide, he didn't let himself get arrested. There was a posse, now the Rebbe had a posse, his name was Rav Shmuel Munkis. And now the Rebbe asked Rav Shmuel Munkis, he said, look, they came to arrest me, should I let myself be arrested or not? He asked Rav Shmuel Munkis, what does he think? Rav Shmuel Munkis told out the Rebbe the following story. He said, Zamaise, of Rav Mendel, in Horodok, Rav Mendel Horodok, and he used to have a Balagol. And then we had to go somewhere in the Balagol, and that was his Uber, we used to call to get the go from point A to point B, wherever we had to go. But came a time when he didn't ask him to go anywhere. He didn't have anywhere to go. He didn't ask him to go. So his whole prognosis was from this temple of Dolphin's rights. He didn't ask. The end was that he had to sell his horse and wagons, he had the money, and he had no horse in the wagon. One day, he gets a call, or a WhatsApp, or a text message, or a clear came to him. And he said to the driver, I have to go somewhere very, very urgent, very quickly, come right away. He didn't even have a horse mind, but that's why I don't have to go. So he went right away, I don't know if he borrowed or rented, or he bought. He went right away, he got a horse mind, and came to pick up and then went up there. So he put where he has to go, told where he has to go. So he said, it's very, very important we get there quickly. The Schmeiss the ferret, look the horse, he could go as fast as he could, and don't stop at nothing, just go fast. So he went, and as they were going downhill, came down the hill, and the road, when he came down the hill, again the hill was third road. But he was pushing the horse, and the horse was going very, very fast, and because it was downhill, so the horses were like out of control, he couldn't even control the horses. And the bottom of the hill lived at Parnas, had a beautiful house there at the bottom of the hill. And the horses, they went, instead of turning on the road to the left, they went straight down into the Parnas' house and they smashed his beautiful patio glass that he had there, the glass door that goes on to his veranda. And the horses went and they smashed the glass. The Parnas heard his glass was being smashed, he ran out of the house. And he came with a gun, and he wanted to see what's going on here. And he saw the horse in the wagon with the driver. And this, he pointed the gun at the driver. He wanted to shoot him. He said, the guy makes it, let him take this and broke the glass from his house. So the driver, right away, he pointed to the metal hard over. He said, it's not me, it's him. He's the one, it's his fault. And he's the one with the rim. He said, go faster, faster, faster. He didn't mind, he didn't take the money. So the parents, he pointed the gun at the veteran of Bethlehem Dorothy, but the gun did not go from the jammed, the snitching guy, he wouldn't, it didn't go at the money. Okay, so the Bethlehem Dorothy asked the driver, excuse me, why did the gun not point to me? But, why did he put me in this big day for you? He had to make a money. So he told them like this, he told them, if you're not then that was not back, the police came back, Ishmael on the Thursday, Ishmael soldiers, they came back out to arrest Al-Talabin, and this time Al-Talabin didn't go into hiding, he didn't go out the back door, the side door, and he was arrested.